in Malaysia, because this is Master Hua's centennial year. This is 100 years of the life of our teacher. He was born in 1918, and we are now in 2018. And of course, this year, what we're doing is we're thinking about how he taught, and what he taught, and what we learned from him, and what a difference it made in our lives that we met this teacher. And if I had to, you know, we do this a lot, and we think, what was it that Sherpa taught that means the most to me? And certainly one of the things that means the most to me about what our teacher taught is his attitude of lifelong learning. Lifelong learning. What does that mean? In Chinese, there's a really perfect phrase for it, which is 活到老学到老. Master Hua talked about, he was certainly a religious teacher, a teacher of religion. And to say that, oh, he was a Buddhist doesn't contain Master Hua. He taught us elementary school, which is to say, 儒家的思想, right? Confucian principles, how to be people. That, in America, that may be the biggest lesson, because people, we don't do people very well. We do machines very well. We don't do people very well. We do materials very well, but we don't even provide health care for our elders. We give health care to our children and then take it away from them, which recently happened in America. 12 million young people were de-insured recently. So that's an important lesson in America, is how to be people, and that's the elementary side of education. And Master Hua said, we also want to learn about ourselves in the world. What is that? That's high school, middle school, the teachings of Taoism, which is what? Master Hua introduced vegetarian eating to most of us. The idea that animals' lives are suffering and it's part of a continuum. Animals are higher than ghosts, but not yet people. And they're not yet devas, right? The six paths, the 10 dharma realms. This is the teaching of the environment. And so people learn about that. He taught us about respecting our elders and cherishing youth. And he taught us how to be frugal, but not penny pinching. How to be frugal, but not tight, right? How to appreciate what we have. And I have to say, I have learned this lesson very well. These are the contents of my pocket. All right? And that people go, Dharma Master, do you have a growth? Do you need to see a surgeon? I say, no, that's my Kleenexes. Master Hua was frugal. He said, don't waste things. Americans waste too much. And this week, watching everybody use things so well, so carefully, and really love the environment and the benefits that it brings us, was a delight for me, because this is a teaching on the environment. We're connected. We are part of and not apart from the universe. Okay? So, use it wisely. Then, when you say 活到老学到老, lifelong learning, Master Hua, love the Dharma. Because why? It connects you to all life itself and to the entire universe. The principles of the Dharma show us how things work. Ordinarily, we don't see them, but they're always there working. The Tao itself, it's invisible, but you can't not see it. It is everything, right? You can't get it, and you can't let it go. So, anyway, this is the teaching of the Dharma, and Master Hua was learning it and teaching it all the time. That's education. So if I say, what in my teacher this year do I appreciate the most? Was what he taught me about lifelong learning. That it's not just going to class with a textbook and doing a test. It's, can you understand this person's pain? What is this person going through? Why do they feel that way? Why do they act that way? If you watch, if you listen, if you refer to the principles and clear up your mind so you can feel what they're experiencing, that's lifelong learning. You can help. You can be of service. you can make your life significant. Right? You're more than just eating and defecating and sleeping. Right? That's what life is about, is in service. And the Dharma helps us understand the deeper principles of the universe and ourselves. That's worth learning. That's what we're here to study. And another really important thing that I saw this week, that I just want to say, and then I'm going to give my, we talk about snapshots, I'm going to hand the microphone to Ching Ho Shi. But the when you approach Master Hua's version of teaching this way, look what it does to the role of the Sangha. Right? The Sangha, are they worthy of offerings, worthy of respect? You know, the way the Theravada chant goes? Well, I hope so. But why would that be the case if you feel that respect? Not because of the robe they wear only, but because of their attitude towards learning. They care for the Dharma and these principles of compassion and kindness so much, they do it full time. They gave up other things because they were not as important as understanding and serving. So why would you respect the Sangha? It's because they're beside you doing it more all the time. Not because they're over your head and you have no choice. Okay? So this kind of learning is circular. Right? And I have to say, one of my snapshots, I'm going to go ahead and just give you one of my snapshots. I couldn't resist. One of the things that I wanted to share, that what do we have? I'll say this now and everybody's going to get a chance to do it. And please don't copy me and talk for 10 minutes. No, won't work. Too many people. I'll give you my snapshot. And the snapshot, a perfect snapshot is about 30 seconds. What is a snapshot? This is part of the Buddha Parm experience, is at the end, we know that we're going to go back down to where we came from, to our home. And I want to say right now, this experience is not over until you return to your driveway. Right? We want everybody back home safely. We've all driven pretty much by car. We all arrived by car. Right? In Oregon, we have to go 10 hours. And every year, we say, do let us know you are home safely. Because it's not over until we're all returned to our driveway. Hello. Road back. So we know the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas are taking care of us, but we don't want to tax the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. We don't want to give Guanyin Bodhisattva more trouble, okay, than she has already. Enough trouble. Even with 1,000 hands, that's a lot of trouble. So we have created a WhatsApp group, a Buddha Root Farm WhatsApp group, and we want everybody to give your handle or your phone number, and please, when you get home safely, if you will just say, back home, Guanyin Bodhisattva can relax. I'm giving you the hand back. Get a free hand now, because I'm safe. Okay? We'd appreciate that if you let us know that everything's back safely. And if something comes up, suppose you don't get back safely. Maybe a flat tire, maybe you realize you left your driver's license back in your sleeping bag or something here. Let us know so we can follow. Okay? That would be very helpful. All right. Here is one of my snapshots, which was, I'm going to wait. Now, I'm not teasing you. I'm going to wait because I'm going to give them all and I'll give better examples. So what I just said was my after lunch Dharma talk, okay? This doesn't count as a snapshot, so nobody copy me. All right. I'll give you my snapshot when it's my turn. I'm going to pass the microphone over to Jim Bush.